legend says, a mountain cannot house more than one dragon. So it says.
To enjoy life, you know, it's like my philosophy is don't stay in, you know, sometimes you have setbacks, but don't stay in that feeling, but try to continue with life and learn from things and go on. It's a different kind of album also, but this Hydra is really symbolizing for us the diversity of how versatile we are as a band, because we have done so many styles within our style, music styles, and every head represents actually a personality of where we stand for. We had of course the Celtic sound in the past, and we have the metal, we have rock influences, we have some pop, some dance, now a little bit of hip hop. So we use a lot of music from different styles and to in this symphonic style that we have. I think that's a big compliment because I love that movie, and it is like it's not inspired by it, but I think if it was, I wanted to let it look like something, it would, yeah, it would be great if it looks like that. I'm happy about that. No, it's coincidence. Molenaar is the one who drew this and made this cover, but he also did the previous one, The Unforgiving. And I think this one turned out way better than the previous one, but also because this is more within his style, how he made it. And we're really happy with this cover. And he also does the X-Men comics in America, and then he does Batman, and I think also the Wolverine. This is who we are, this is what we've got. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, what we tried to do with Hydra, it was something that we realized while we were working on it, that bringing back certain elements from the past, so like the growling voices, we hadn't used for a long time, and that's since 2003, but in a new way again, not together with the classical voice, but with the voice that I'm using now more in days, and together with the fact that the guitars are back, but not in a doom metal way, but more in an up-tempo way. And so it's a combination of old and new, old elements, but in how we sound nowadays. And it's an overview from things that we've done in the last 17 years that we've been around. It gives more color to the album. It's not necessary for us to do it, but it's more like that we, you know, in the beginning was like, oh god, there's quite a lot, four, but we didn't want to skip one of them because they're all so special in their own way, and also they all bring so much character, again, extra as extra character with their voice into this music, and I'm glad we did it actually. More color. The song has some elements of Killswitch Engage to our point, the double bass and the heaviness, the tempo a little bit also, and we felt like, oh, you know, if it has some overlap, and we were just thinking, oh, it has some, you know, musical elements from Killswitch Engage, and he just left the band, and we were following this band already for quite some time because we liked the music. And we thought, like, okay, if it has some overlap, why not ask him actually, you know, like, it might be really cool having him doing some screams and stuff, and then he came back with this more epic kind of voice that we don't know that much, that well of him actually. But it turned out way better than we ever thought, because we thought he was going to do some screams, but he came back with this really beautiful voice, and it's like, yeah, suits the song even better, to my opinion. I've always tried new things, and like last album was Sinead, with more dance influences, and we are people that like all kinds of music, and we like to experiment, and this is one of we had a certain vision about how these two styles could be combining be combined together. Sorry,
no problem.
And I think on this song we tried many songs actually to combine it with, but it was the only song where it worked actually, and it's a really a typical invitation song, really bombastic and big and orchestral, and adding him to it became. Yeah, for us it was like something we had in our mind, like it could be really cool, and it just worked like really cool, I think. It's one of my favorite songs on the album. Mm-hmm. Well, I know, I knew who she was, of course, but and I knew the band she was in, and her music and the way she sang. But I didn't know the person behind the voice and the face, and I must say, she surprised me 180 degrees because, you know, a lot of people said that she was a diva and stuff, and I must say that I didn't experience that at all. Actually, the contrary, I find she has a very warm personality and probably one of the nicest female vocalists I met. It's gonna have, of course, the covering somehow integrated in our the art was gonna be there, of course, somehow, and I'm not sure yet how we're gonna solve the problem between of the guest artists who can't be there, maybe, or can be there, but we have to find a way. But in the past we did it with just filming them and putting them on the screen, and sometimes it might be just somebody out of the audience or maybe someone from the supporting act who might like to sing the same song. It depends a little bit on how things work out. Oh, that's difficult because, you know, it's for different people. I think like the guys really were so much in love with Iron Maiden always. And Iron Maiden is also, it's always been great to play for them. And also Metallica is also like a sentiment from the past, and still now we like their albums, also new stuff. And also with Iron Maiden, but for me personally, it was Paradise Lost. Because that really got us in making the music that we did, combining with our love for Dead Can Dance and Planet, in combination with the influences of Paradise Lost. That's how we built our first inspiration for. I'm especially a fan of fantasy, like this George R. Martin who did now what's called Game of Thrones. It's now huge, but I read those books like 10 years ago or maybe longer. So I knew the whole story already, and I was really happy that they finally made the series, because then I could pick up the new book that he wrote, because there's so many characters there that it's very difficult to remember, like, oh, what happened again? Because you have to reread everything again to get into the story, because there's so many storylines. And so now I just can watch it and that happened. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then I can see the new part, which is going to be filmed now, that I haven't seen yet, so it's, I'm curious what's going to happen. I can also read the book now. So. But I'm more into fantasy. I always was into fantasy because, I don't know, it appeals to me more than horror. But I must say that the guys, especially Robert and Jeroen, the bass player, mm-hmm. they watched a lot of horror movies, and they liked it a lot. Yeah, especially because they were very funny most of the time. And, but I don't like blood, so it's like, Yes, that's the thing that really got us started into this music. Yeah, together with Paradise Lost and Clannad. Although Death Can Dance was even more so. I like her voice and the way that they were a bit strange kind of songs without real structure, but they were very imaginary. Of course, we have a lot of drug tourism because of the fact that we do have it. And there's now a lot, there's now a campaign going on in Holland, more or less, that they want to legalize it. But legalize, because now it's illegal, but you can use it, but you can't have too many with you. So it's a bit strange, of course, and but I'm pro. Because I think if you legalize it, there's also a lot of people gain from it medically. And on the other side, if it's controlled, you can also control the quality of it. Nowadays, because it became more kind of illegal in Holland as well, it totally, the kind of cannabis has become very hard and very strong. So people really respond strongly to it. But I also see that there's a downside to the cannabis, and I also see that it is addictive in a way. And it's like alcohol, but alcohol is also allowed, and we also have the problems of that. So, you know, maybe if you legalize it, you can also see, help people when they have problems. So people look at it at different angles, but I'm pro. Yes.